Okay, the difficulty we were having earlier with the demonstration, we're still having that difficulty. It is related to the internet, sort of, but I think it's not necessarily connectivity. But I have a different example that I'm going to show you. And it's similar. So after following along from this demonstration, I don't know that you'll be able to do the exercise we planned on it, so I will create one for this as well. But the taxonomic resolution exercise, if you'll refine, it'll still be on our schedule. So maybe when you're at home, you can try that one at home or something. But what this is, so I already opened the file and created it, and we've got the in the kind field, our list of scientific names. I'm still going to go to reconcile, and I'm going to start reconciling. But this time, I'm going to use a service that's already available within Refine. And the way I found this service was I clicked on the Add Namespace service, and I started typing in well-known groups that I thought might have a web service. So I typed in IDIS, and I typed in EOL, and I found the IDIS one. So that's how I added that. So I'm going to select it, and see this where it says working, that's what the other one was supposed to look like. And then it goes out and it provides back a list of types that you could use to reconcile against, but we're gonna, we don't wanna specify anything specific to reconcile against, so I chose reconcile against no particular type, and then I click the start reconciling button. And I'm only doing 8 records. The more records you have, the longer this will take. Now, the previous exercise that I was going to show you, it was actually going to match on scientific names. This one is doing a bit of a different thing. It's actually going to return common name. But it's the same idea. So, in blue, down the list, it took all those scientific names and matched them on common name. Well, that, you know, that's pretty cool. You brought back some data you might not have otherwise had. But now it's like you've lost your original data that showed you what the scientific name was. So the first thing I'm going to do is bring that back. Actually, I'm not going to bring it back yet. I'm going to add some other things first, then we'll bring it back. Some other functionalities that exist in here. You can add additional columns, and we did that yesterday, where we added the column for the occurrence ID. This time we're going to add columns from Freebase. And again, Freebase is a background database that exists within Google Refine. And so it brings up a list of different database properties that have columns that we can add. And I'm going to do a search for, I'm going to search for taxon to see what it brings back. And to the right of all those, it shows you different databases within the Freebase that, that it's pulling these names from. One thing I'm going to bring back first is the IDIS taxon serial number. So I'm going to bring back this ID number, which can then be used to link back to the IDIS database in other ways. scientific names. I also am going to look for rank. There's so many different ones that you don't always get the one that has the information that you're looking for. And then that brought back the species. So I'm going to click OK, and it's going to add those fields to the database. And this, I haven't played with this a whole lot, but there's a lot of good information out in Freebase. And if you go, there's a Freebase website you can go to, and you can actually examine some of the databases and be more familiar with which database you should be looking at when you're searching in here. So it added those three fields. And so now you have some data you might not have otherwise had. Now I'm going to go back, and I'm going to make a new column based on this common name data that it returned back. I want to edit column and then add column based on this column. And as you start using these different cell formulas, it remembers them. And I'm going to use the cell recon match name. And that one was part of the instructions from the demo on the taxonomic resolution. And you can see what it's going to preview for you. So it shows our original value, which was the scientific name, and then it's showing the common name. I'm going to call this field common name. And then I'm going to undo the reconciliation that I did so that we can see our original scientific. And so now you can go back and you can examine for all the data you brought back, does that make sense with your original scientific name? And so the scientific names it brought back did all match. Now, the exercise from earlier today would have matched on scientific name and might have brought you back the full scientific name with perhaps author in it. It might have brought you back several values if the taxonomic name had changed over time and you could pick the one you wanted to use. So that one is a different scenario than this, but the functionality is very similar in how they work. And then the last thing I'm going to show you isn't related to the taxon, it's related to the dates. And the dates that are in this data set are completely in the wrong order or the wrong format. And so it's got the slashes in there. There's a common transform in here. So if you click on edit cells and do common transforms, and there's one for dates, and if you click on that, it turns all the dates into the proper ISO format for